What's up guys, it's your boy Hayden, Huynh, back in another video, and today I'm going to be talking about something really unique. Now, CTE shirts. I think that every man and their dog, when it comes to Michael Jackson performing, owns one. As you can see that I'm wearing one. As you can see, it's a popular Michael Jackson casual shirt that everyone likes to wear. You're probably wearing them right now after when you finish your dance practice or during your dance practice to watch my videos, which I really appreciate. Now look, see, I love a great CTE shirt. I love the military characteristic that it has, but look, Michael Jackson wore it. But that being said, you know, some costumes I don't agree with Michael Jackson wearing. Well, it looks good on him, but it doesn't look good on me. Case in point, the Dangerous World Tour leotard. That crotch piece, look, it does me dirty. But CTE shirts, I feel that it's very aggressive for what it is. Well, since it's a military shirt, yes. But look at the CTE shirt that I'm wearing at the moment. Look, I'm just gonna give you a little bit of a tour of what it looks like. Do you see any difference? And yes, there is a difference between my CTE shirt and Michael Jackson's 90s CTE shirt. Can you see the difference? So as you can see, I have removed the actual CTE lettering on here and I have removed the armband on the right arm. Now you're probably thinking, Hayden, why? Now this isn't the shirt that I've only modified. I have modified my other CTE shirts. So as you can see, I've got the black on. This is my white, and this one's the red one. I actually lied. This one's a much more better CTE shirt that I've bought, and I'll explain to you why in a second. But as you can see, the white CTE shirt, it doesn't have the CTE lettering, but I've also kept the armband. You can't see the, there you go, the military decals on here as well. But I figured that, you know, the black is probably the most safest option for me to actually wear out. The white is usually more for performing. And the red one is, you know, this is the variation that I really love, which is courtesy of our sponsor, which is Trident Store. If you use the offer code HUNTEN, you can get 10% off your purchase. Links will be down in the description below. You can check out what Trident Store has to offer. They offer a lot of Michael Jackson merchandise and a lot of products and a lot of clothing that I really, really love. So as you can see, I've got all the CTE shirts, but only one of them is actually intact. Let me get into it. So the black CTE shirt that I've decided to modify is actually based on the bad version of the CTE shirt. Now, what do you mean by the bad version? Well, if you look at 1988 and 1989 pictures of Michael Jackson, you can actually see that he's wearing this exact same shirt. Some of them include the armband and some of them don't. You can also see that there's no CTE lettering on the epaulets, which is, you know, perfectly fine. It's a prototype shirt. I think having this modification look, it looks pretty fine, looks pretty symmetrical. I hate having the armband on it, especially with like the military insignia, and I'll get into it later. But the first and foremost thing is, I really hate those Michael Jackson costume makers that actually have, you know, the crappy stitch on lettering and the armband. Now, what do you mean by this? Now, if you look at this video, you can see that the CTE, it's like in a square and then it's stitched on. And then if you compare it to this CTE shirt, you can see that the lettering is much more high quality stitched and that it just looks clean. Like the old CTE lettering, it just looks really bad, looks really cheap. Look, it looks great from afar, but if you're doing like these close-up macro shots, it looks really jarring, you know. There's no smooth transitioning in the middle of it. And look, I used to wear CTE shirts in public and people used to ask me, what does CTE mean? Like, what? Like, why do you have these random letterings? And each time I'm like, oh, you know, I'm a Michael Jackson fan. CTE means insert meaning here, yada, yada, yada. If you don't get it, you're not gonna know. And it reminds me, the CTE lettering, it reminds me of those like random Shein fashion shirts that you get. And like, it just has the word fashion or like men's style on it. Like, it's something really random. And you know, to people who are not fans of MJ, just like, that's a weird shirt. Like, I like the shirt, but CTE, like, what does that mean? And just like, okay, cool. And you're like, well, actually, this is the story of CTE shirts. It's just like, what a pain in the butt. Number two is, if you're actually wearing a CTE shirt in public, don't put a graphic tee underneath. You look like a kid and it looks just really foolish. Just wear it as is, like a long sleeve shirt, and it looks really good paired with a blazer. That way it looks really flush. It's not as attention seeking as it is. Obviously that CTE shirts are very like a statement piece, and obviously it's very Michael Jackson-y. So always just wear them related to Michael Jackson. Don't wear them to like, see people like, yeah, I'm gonna go to the shops and wear my CTE shirt. It's just like, what, huh, what? Just wear them for a purpose. Don't wear them casually. Don't be like, oh, you know, hanging out with my friends with my CTE shirt. Like, I used to do that, and, you know, on retrospect, looking back to it, it just looks weird. Obviously, CTE shirts are very, like, it's a niche shirt. If you're not a Michael Jackson fan, you know, like, it's like, that's a weird shirt that you're wearing. It's very statementy, it's very bold. Which leads me to my next point is wear them appropriately. Like what I mentioned, CTE shirts, you know, they're obviously Michael Jackson associated. So just wear them to Michael Jackson events or like when you're dancing. Obviously, if you're watching my channel, you're either a Michael Jackson fan or a Michael Jackson performer. You know, that's perfectly fine. But you know, don't wear them, you know, when you're going grocery shopping or just like doing random stuff or like to school. Like just wear them appropriately. An example would be, one time I wore these CTE shirts to the War Memorial. That was a bad move. Like, it was really, really hot as well, and like, I wanted to take off my blazer, but I was just strictly embarrassed because it is a military shirt, not even a military shirt, it's a fake military shirt at a war memorial. The disrespect on that, that's just crazy. And you know, it has like the fake insignia here, the fake CTE ranks here. It just looks really dumb. It looks really stupid in context in the war memorial. And you've got actually veterans, you know, who've risked their lives and who have comrades who've fallen and died due to war and other stuff. So obviously just wear them in precaution. And look, if you're wearing them as a stage outfit, don't go overboard. As you can see here in this article, a K-pop band actually, you know, since the shirts are military and they are trying to look like, you know, I'm not gonna say it, but I'm gonna just put this image here. Do you see it? Do you see the resemblance? And the last thing is that, you know, the CTE shirt, although if you're in the know that it's a military shirt that MJ wore, it has negative connotations as a Nazi uniform. Look, I'll show you. So if you're looking at the black shirt as pictured here versus the Nazi uniform here, look, isn't it obvious? Look, I'm not saying that just because you're wearing a CTE shirt, you're obviously a Nazi. That's like, pff, that's really stupid. But a lot of people who aren't in the know will automatically assume that, you know, there is some negative connotation around it. That's why I choose to remove the armband and choose to remove the CTE. So I still got the shirt in its integrity, but you know, it's very subtle and it just looks overall nicer. The red one reminds me of the Canadian Guards, I think. I'm not too sure what the specific term is, but you know, if you look at the red shirt and you compare them to, I think it's like the Canadian Rangers, the National Park look, you can obviously see that, you know, there's a bit of a connotation and correlation to it. So that's why I don't wear the red one often. And you know, obviously has an armband as well, but this one's a really high quality replica of the MJ CTE shirt. So I'm just gonna keep this. And if I ever perform songs, then I'm gonna use this one. The black one, you know, I'm probably gonna wear this. This is probably the most appropriate to wear on a casual day out. And the white one is obviously for performance as well. I've removed the CTE off, but I kept the armband because it's a very man in the mirror piece, and you know, I just wanna keep it as is. So what I've actually done is I've modified the white and the black, but I've also ordered, you know, just straight up CTE better replicas in the black and white to replace them. And I've got red because, you know, I just want to keep the red one as is. And some people think that you're actually impersonating the military or police, which there's actually legal repercussions of. This thing is called stolen valor, and people actually wear fake military, like real genuine military uniforms, you know, the United States Army, the Australian Army, all that. They even wear the medals even to, you know, just grab like a veteran's discount order and, you know, just, you know, the veteran army benefits in which they've never served before. And you know, it's literally stolen valor, and it's basically just a disrespect to the military in a whole. You know, as you can see in this video, that we've got a person who, you know, is obviously just wearing the military clothes for the clout and getting discounts.
You don't say anything, okay? Come here. Come here. Hey, sir. Hey, my son would like to meet you. He really admires guys in the army.
Hey, buddy. I'm Sean.
What unit were you in?
I'm with the 2nd Battalion Rangers.
75th?
2nd. We're 75th Ranger Regiment with the 2nd Battalion.
What's your MOS?
My MOS is 11 Bravo.
All right.
I'm what's called Attack 1. All I do is I go out on missions.
Where'd you get your 3 CIBs at?
Afghanistan.
All 3?
All 3.
You know you need to be in 3 different campaigns to get 3 CIBs, right?
This one was from Afghanistan.
Okay.
That's from Iraq.
Okay.
And that was for my 2nd rotation back to Afghanistan.
You know, no matter how many you do, you can only get one. For Iraq, Afghanistan, yep. All 3, you can only get them. You know that, right?
Because my campaign took me outside of mission lines from Afghanistan.
That doesn't make any sense. And you're in second bet? Rangers?
Yep.
There it is. Where's your combat patch at?
I gave it to a little kid again.
All right, watch your flag so low on your shoulder. It should be up here.
Got me on that one, bud.
Why are your boots are all on blast, too?
Because I literally just got home.
From where?
From Fort Lewis.
Fort Lewis? Is that where the Rangers are?
That's where we're stationed.
How come, where's your shirt underneath? Your tan t-shirt. What's your rank?
I'm a staff sergeant.
Staff sergeant? Where'd you go to basic training?
Fort Jackson.
Fort Jackson? You know, only the infantry only goes to Fort Benning, right?
Yeah, for Ranger training.
No, for basic training.
No, I didn't start off as a Ranger, as infantry.
You didn't? What'd you start off as?
I started off as a M1, as a driver for Humvees.
What's the actual MOS for that, for a driver?
My driver MOS, hold on one second. Staff sergeant.
Staff sergeant. He's calling a staff sergeant. Why is he calling a staff sergeant, if he's already a staff sergeant? That doesn't make much sense.
Hey, where are you?
Come here.
Okay. You want me to meet you there?
He's calling a staff sergeant, when he's wearing the rank of a staff sergeant. That makes much sense.
Okay.
Here it is, guys. Stolen valor at its finest.
Okay.
He's full of shit. Wearing a United States Army uniform. Claims to be a United States Army Ranger.
Okay, listen, what we're going to do is we're going to step down here.
Okay.
With my Sergeant Major.
All right, let's go. Let's see your Sergeant Major. So you shop at the mall with Sergeant Major on Black Friday?
Sometimes.
Yeah? That's cool. Why don't you just admit you're a phony? You know it's illegal, right? What you're doing right now?
Let me tell you something. If I was a phony,
yeah,
then I wouldn't be wearing this uniform.
You wouldn't?
No.
Because you are a phony. I just called you out about 10 different things. And all of them are bullshit. This is illegal. What you're doing right now is illegal. Because you know what? I've worn that fucking uniform. And I've had friends get killed in Afghanistan wearing that fucking uniform. No, you haven't.
That's
you're full of shit.
12 years in.
Stone Valor. Right here. Stone Valor.
Hey, let's go. Stop it.
At its finest. What's your name, dude? Okay. Thanks, buddy. See you later, pal. Go have fun with your Sergeant Major at lunch. Fucking asshole.
While a real military person is basically just straight up saying, like, what the heck are you doing? Like, you're disrespecting me and my comrades and all that stuff. Like, it's just really bad. And that, you know, I don't want people to say that, you know, negative connotations with me saying that, you know, I am impersonating police or the military, or there's negative connotations of having, you know, a Nazi uniform. So that's why I choose to remove the CTE and the armband. Overall, it looks better, you know, to be honest, it looks more casual. This video has been like a completely different video, maybe to what you expected, but those are my thoughts on the CTE shirts and why I chose to remove the CTE, the armband, and basically modify it. And those are my thoughts regarding on the CTE shirts. Hope you enjoy, like, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Catch you around.